Well, first of all, it's an orientation how important their health is, especially as busy moms. They want to be there for their kids and they want to be there long term. But, you know, the moment to moment, that instant gratification, they're running around like crazy and their emphasis isn't about them, it's about their kids. So they don't really pay attention to all those little daily choices they make that are either making them healthy or bringing them down towards disease. And long term, as their kids get bigger, their parents need to be there for them. And so what they need to do is first think about being healthy and think about that being a priority in their life.
So give us some of the steps that you go through when it comes to coaching someone.
Well, the first thing I want to do is I ask the simple question, you know, we had talked about that earlier. If you could choose optimal health, would you make that choice? And the answer is yes. People may say, I'm not sure. Well, I'm not asking if you think you can do it, but if you wanted that, if it was important to you. Because what happens then is your changes and your choices then are decided by that. It's like freedom. It's not until it's gone that we realize how important it is. So I start off with being mindful. Mindfulness is something we don't do. You know, thinking about, God, I got to get Sally to the school, or I got to do this, or I got to do that. They're not thinking right now what's in front of me. Just a couple moments of taking a deep breath and becoming aware of your surroundings and thinking, okay, if I'm not feeling quite right, rather than grab for some candy or be sitting on the couch, let me stop, challenge why I'm feeling like that, and what do I want? Well, I want to choose an outcome that'll move me forward and create health for myself.
So it's really not just a change for the time being, it's a lifestyle change.
Exactly. And it changes with that orientation. I call it a health orientation. And actually, we have to be responsible for our health in modern day. The obesogenic world, from the time you get up to the time you go to bed, the food industry is trying to feed you things that are energy dense, that are going to actually make you overweight and obese. 70% of us are overweight or obese. Also, machines telling you, no, don't do that, don't lift that hand, you know, don't do that. And we have to just say no to that. We need to get back to the point where we're focusing on the things that actually support long-term health.
Let's talk about Shirley's case. She had a dramatic weight loss and did it the right way. What was your advice to her when you first met her?
Well, the right way, she's got to do it because she makes a decision. It comes from, you have to take ownership. You have to decide, you know what, I want to change. I want to be the ownership. I want to take the actions and I want to do it because I want to do it. If someone outside of you tells you to do it, you may comply for a short period of time, but you're not going to have long-term success. But if you make the decision and it's volitional, it comes from within you, then you want to get good at it. And that's what Shirley's done. She has taken all the steps that are necessary, the habits of health, has put them into her daily life, and now is amazing. As you've seen the pictures, just a transformation. And Shirley will never go back. Shirley has transformed herself. That transcendence from being someone that didn't think and wasn't mindful to now every day she makes choices. Now she has a ball. She's having a lot more fun because when you're 200 plus pounds down, boy, life opens up to you. And it's like this person just unzipped themselves and walked out. She's got a great personality, which you'll see. Great person, and now I know she'll never go back.
Let's actually get into some of the specifics of what it is that you're teaching when it comes to how they have to change their diet and what they have to do differently day to day.
Well, it's basically not just your diet. See, the diet is one thing, and everybody focuses. We either are exercise enthusiasts or diet enthusiasts. But it's really all the little daily choices that make all the difference. We make over 200 food choices a day. We make about 1,600 choices that involve areas where you can either improve or make your health worse. So it's not just what you eat, but how you move, how you sleep, how you handle stress. All those things are critical. But by making little baby steps, and it starts certainly with food. You know, there's a lot of energy-dense food out there, and it actually doesn't taste as good as real food does. So we start by, and Shirley will talk about that, all the things you can do as a busy mom throughout the day that will allow you to move forward, be healthy, enjoy all the tastes. We love tastes. Tastes are an important part. The gregarious part of eating with the family is all very important. But 95% of our taste satisfaction comes in the first three bites. So if you're itching to have one of those forbidden foods, you can have a couple bites of it. It doesn't really matter. But day in and day out, by making the choices, by eating low glycemic food, by eating whole foods and foods that have lots of water content, boy, it can make all the difference in the world.
Now, are you also incorporating an exercise regimen in it?
Really, if you think about it, we have 168 hours in the week. What we do is we spend so much time focusing on those 3 hours going to the gym. Well, as a mom, it's pretty hard. And if you can make room and, you know, get a babysitter or get someone to take care of the kids, that's a great thing. It's a great way to get a blow off steam. But it's the day-to-day choices, the hour-to-hour choices that you make. So what I'm really more in is an activity program where you just start doing more. Just standing up. You know, what I do is I put a headset on, and when I'm not, I don't have to sit at my desk and write something. I'm standing up, and I'm burning about another 50 calories an hour just by being up and moving around. It's all these little things you can do that make the difference.
Can you give us some specifics about Shirley and what you suggested obviously you said it's not only about diet, but about changing everything in the course of the day. What did you suggest for her?
Well, the thing for her, Shirley was very busy. She had a lot of stuff going on, and she needed to help in the beginning. So I actually used meal replacements. Meal replacements are a great way to get started. They kind of jumpstart you. You lose 2 to 5 pounds per week, and as you're losing weight, then you get in the teachable moment, and then you're ready to learn more. Now, Shirley's had, you know, the last couple of years have been a great journey for her. The other part is I've actually encouraged her to become a coach, and now she's coaching others. And when you start coaching others, it can really make a difference too. So what's neat about it is with a busy family like Shirley has, you're able to basically go out, do things, have fun, and enjoy your life at the same time focus on making sure you make the right choices.